Hello again, everyone. Welcome to another Transformers review. This is Graham, also known as the Collector 75. Now then, for my next review, I thought I would do a Transformer that was requested to me. I can't remember now, because my memory's terrible, to be honest, whether it was for my like 400 subscribers one or whether it was just a normal request. Either way, I said I would do it, and so here we go. This is it. Now then, here we go. This is Generation 1 Punch Counter Punch. This is him in his nice, almost mint box. Unfortunately, the insert I had to make myself, but the outer box is near enough mint. There we go, that is him. Nice little bit of artwork on the front there. That's both his robot mode, Autobot and Decepticon, because this guy is a double spy. Really, really good. Sort of like a counter to, because I believe he came out in the same year, which was... I can't think of his name for the life of me. That's right out of my head. Double Dealer. There we go. Why can't I remember that? That's strange. Anyway, yeah. So almost a thing for Double Dealer because he was basically the same. He was an Autobot and a Decepticon. And so this guy was an Autobot and Decepticon, but on the Autobot side. Even though if you read like his bio in some of the comics and later in like the IDW More Than Meets the Eye guidebook and stuff like that, it did expand it as to where he would like black out for days and not know what he's done as a Decepticon and had his like schizophrenic personality coming through and everything like that, which was really cool. Really liked it. Anyway, right. This is the back of the box. Got his usual scene from 1987 or 88. I can't remember which year exactly this came out, to be honest, but he is in the Rebirth. And I was a bit gutted because they never released this guy in England. And when I saw him in the Rebirth, I saw all these cool Transformers that just weren't released in England. I was so gutted. This guy, the clones, and I mean, they're only in it for like, not even, well, like a minute or two, really. But I just really, really wanted them. I got this from a guy in Shepparton a few years ago. I'm going to open it now anyway. Yeah, I got this from a guy in Shepparton a few years ago. And it was completely mint, apart from it didn't have the insert. But I made this, which I'm going to show you now. Just going to take it out. I used to work for a sort of like a binder company. We used to make boxes, like slip cases and stuff like that for books and all sort of manner of stuff. And I learned how to make boxes. Quite easy, really, once you know. So I just made up a few of my own, nicked all their cardboard. And yeah, so I've just done this for myself. So there we go. And I just used all the little tassels that you get in new Transformers to hold them in place. Anyway, there we go. Let's see, this has got his little weapons and his little thing. He's got little instructions. I'm going to take out his little guns. Now then, there we go. Let's see, here's his little two guns. Going to pop them down there. Now then, we're going to get this figure out. I used some really thick ties, unfortunately, on this little guy. But hopefully, I just need to loosen them up, if I remember rightly. And I should be able to slide this figure out. Maybe I'll just need to undo these back ones. There we go. We're just going to pop that over there. Now then, this is him in his car mode. I can't remember what exactly car this is supposed to be based on. I don't know if it's a Corvette or something like that. I ain't got a clue. I'm sure someone out there knows. Now then, I was a bit silly when I first bought this because I bought this during the dark, dark days of Generation 2 when no one wanted Transformers whatsoever. So I got this guy for about 10 or 15 quid. I can't remember now. He was mint, and but I decided to paint bits on him. I mean, I can't believe I did it now, but he's so plain. I mean, he's got hardly any paint applications at all. Yes, so I was a bit naughty, but I managed to cover some of them up now because I've got some spare, I had some spare labels left over from Repro labels, and I just sort of cut them out very finely, and I just done my own details. On the sorry, losing my voice there. Done my own little details on the front there. I've done some headlights and like little grill section. And I've done the same on the back to put some rear lights and another light, whatever you want to call that, number plate sort of thing there, or if you're American, license plate. There we go. Nice bit of trivia. Anyway, yeah, there we go. He's got nice little red alloy wheels, if you want to call them that. He looks pretty good. I mean, could have been done with some stickers just there to represent the back windows, but, you know, it's not important. Anyway, he's pretty cool car. He rolls quite well. Can't see that, but he does roll well. Yeah, pretty good. Right, we're going to take this guy to Autobot mode. Now then, I've got to remember how to do this without ripping the stickers off the legs. But here we go. Now then, I believe we pull this. Oh, there we go. Pull that out. Now then, we flip this around and backwards like that. Oh, like that, I believe. And then we pull them out, I think. Do you know what? It's been so long since I've done this, I'm probably going to break it. There you go. I should have Transformers really before I did it really, because I'm probably going to break it. Right, there we go. That's it. There we go. Something like that. I can't remember if I've got to pull them apart or not. Do you know that? There we go. I know you do that. Oh my god, this is terrible, isn't it? I can't believe it. Oh, there we go. That's it. There we go. There we go. That will teach me not to think that I know how to transform it automatically. But this is how we do the legs. It is a bit fiddly. And these stickers were mint when I put them on, because I got it with the stickers and everything. But I don't know if you're going to be able to see this, but the arch is ripped off because parts just grind against each other, which is unfortunate. Anyway, next bit is fairly simple. We just take the bonnet part and separate them down to the sides, like so. I like to be a bit careful on this because these joints do look like they just want to break off. Anyway, put them down to the sides, like so. Now then, we pull these little, you can just about see these little red hands in there. We're going to pull these out if I can get to them, like so. And like so. It's got a little tab there, actually. I just remembered that. So I've had this go out of the box for about 5 years, maybe. I don't know. I can't remember now. Anyway, I think before I push these legs forward, I'll supposedly do something else. But we shall see. What we shall see. We're going to push this. Do you know what? I can't remember. Oh, no, there we go. You are supposed to do it like that. It's terrible, isn't it? Anyway, we open up the roof section. It's a terrible review. Anyway, there we go. Right, we're going to flip his head up. There we go. Flip that back into place. Right then. Now then. Here we go. This is him. Now then, I stupidly, what have I done here? I put a little blue sticker on his little head there, just give him a little bit of detail. And I painted the eyes red because it was just a silver face and it was awful. I suppose I should have done blue eyes really, because he's an Autobot, but there we go. And I also painted all these little things. I've covered them over with stickers now because they were really, really bad. Believe me, they were terrible. Anyway, so it doesn't look too bad now, because I've done my own little stickers for him. Hopefully Repro Labels would do something, but they never did, so, you know. Anyway, this is him, and he's a little cool. Now then, Punch has the yellow gun. We're just going to pop that in there, like that. There we go. This is Punch in his robot mode. He's not got too bad articulation. His arms are moving like that, but that's about it, unfortunately. Now then, we're going to transform this guy to Counter Punch. Take his little gun out. We put the arms away, like so. Like that. Now then, really easy bit of trickery. We're going to spin him around. And here we go. Now we flip out these little toes on the back there, like so. And now then we're going to rotate these up and bend them out to the sides like that. And now then he has other arms tucked away that we're going to flip out because he's got a little tab there. Now he's going to have blue arms just there, like so. Oh, there we go. Now we're going to tilt those that way. Now then, we've got his little head there. We're going to flip his little helmet up and into place, revealing some eyes that I put on, little stickers. I don't think you're going to see that too well, but that's it. Because otherwise it was just all silver and it was terribly, terribly plain and I hated it. Now then, the only way you could tell these guys apart, because they did come with their own rub symbols each. Now then. Punches was on the back here, and if I warm that up on the light, let's see if we can do that for a second. There we go. I don't know if you're going to be able to see that in there, but it is the Autobot one. Now then, Counter Punches, we just open up the roof section again, and this time we flip this panel all the way like that, and this gives him his Decepticon rub symbol, and that is just there like that. Also, I don't think you see that I put a little Decepticon insignia just there because it was a little hidden and it only comes out in his Decepticon mode. It'd be great if they could like do a universe figure for this guy, only really do it really better than this, because, I mean, I actually really do like this. It sounds like I'm being a bit negative on it, but I really do like this figure. Anyway, we get his little gun. That goes in there. The only thing I do have a gripe about in this mode is the arms are just a tiny bit set back, because like when you put them like that, the arms are like really to his back like that, so you've got to tilt them forward. But other than that, I really do like this guy. This is Counter Punch. To be honest, I usually display him in Counter Punch mode because, well, I'm a bit of a Decepticon fan, so as you can see by the t-shirt. Anyway, there we go. That is Counter Punch. I hope you like this review. Sorry about not being known how to transform it, but there you go. I just thought I already knew because I thought it'd be that simple, but there we go. How wrong I was. Anyway, hope you liked it, and I'll see you all next time. Thank you.